Hey, Kris, thanks for coming to Maple Grove today.
Hey, my pleasure. Glad to be here.
We're going to ask you some questions. The first one is, do you skate?
Of course I skate. I was born in Canada. We're practically born with skates on.
Great. Let's go. The next question is,
what size?
Size 11, please. Thank you very much.
Hey, Kris, do you own skates?
Of course I own skates. Unfortunately, they're still in storage, but I can't wait to get my own blades back. Nothing feels better on your feet than your own skates.
We're excited for you to be here in Minnesota. What do you think of it so far?
Oh, it's been fantastic so far. People have been so warm and welcoming, it's like I haven't left home.
They call that Minnesota nice here. What's a Canadian saying that Minnesotans should know about?
Well, one everyone should know about is giver, or I'll say it a little more Canadian. Giver, eh? It means give it your best, give it your best shot, and leave it all on the table.
If you had to create a slogan for your life, what would it be?
Live, love, relax.
What's your preferred social media?
Twitter. Love the Twitter.
How can people follow you?
Well, that's a little easier said than done. It's just my first and last name, but they're both tricky, so I'll spell it out for you. KRISLAUDIEN. That's where you can find me.
Now for some very serious questions. Cats or dogs?
Always have to make a distinction. I'll go with dogs.
Cake or pie?
Cake, especially cheesecake. Love it.
Running or walking?
I'm going to go right in the middle. I'll go with hiking.
If you could have a superpower, what would you choose?
The superpower of elasticity, because I'd love to sit on the couch during the big game and just have my arm extend to the fridge, open that door, grab an ice cold brewski, and return it right to me on the couch without lifting my rear end.
If you were stranded on a desert island, what three items would you bring?
Number one would have to be a toothbrush, because I hate grimy teeth. Also, I need some music, so there'd have to be some kind of music on there. And I'd probably grab one of my best friends. I don't know if they'd like it so much, but it would definitely keep me entertained on a desert island.
You used to anchor mornings in Canada. You're here to anchor KARE 11 Sunrise. When did you get your start in mornings?
That actually started about a dozen years ago at a talk radio station in Vancouver, Canada.
After so many years waking up early to inform people, the obvious question is, what's your favorite caffeinated beverage?
Actually, I'm not big on the caffeine. Don't drink a lot of it. I don't even drink coffee.
Then how do you stay upbeat in the early mornings?
Well, a lot of it has to do with staying active during the rest of the day and drinking a lot of water. Gotta stay hydrated.
Well, you've come to the right state then. Minnesotans have a lot of love of sport in any season. What's your favorite winter sport?
Oh, it'd have to be hockey. Doesn't mean I'm good at playing it, but I love watching it.
And we have to ask, what's your favorite NHL team?
It'd have to go there. I figured that. The team of my youth, the Vancouver Canucks.
We'll have to work on that. What's your favorite season?
Summer.
And what's your favorite summer outdoor activity?
Oh, I love the hiking, the biking, and just sitting on a patio and chilling out.
Besides getting out in the great outdoors, what else do you enjoy in your free time?
History. I have a great love of Second World War history. Also love music.
And so from play to work, what do you like best about anchoring a morning show?
Oh, the fact that you get to inform people about what happened while they were sleeping and also have a good time.
What drew you to KARE 11?
Well, their commitment to journalism and their presence in the community. That's what local TV is all about, and they have a huge commitment to community.
In one sentence, what are you looking forward to in your new job?
Oh, that's simple. To inform, to entertain, surprise, and have a lot of fun.
We love fun. Are you ready to skate?
Yeah, sure, let's get this on.
Who taught you to skate?
That'd be my dad, old man Laudien.
What's the strangest thing you've done in your career so far?
Oh, believe it or not, I was actually in a fish taco eating contest with Joey Chestnut, the same Joey Chestnut that won the Coney Island hot dog eating contest numerous times. We went mano a mano. I lost badly. That man can eat, let me tell you. It wasn't even close.
What story are you most proud of?
Oh, when I was at the Olympics in 2010, learning about what all those athletes went through to get to the top of their sport, the perseverance, the dedication, and the commitment absolutely amazed me.
What's most important to you when you wake up in the morning?
A music, gotta have my beats.
What's the first album you ever bought?
Well, that was a long time ago. That was Billy Idol, Rebel Yell.
Was it on vinyl, cassette, CD, or 8-track?
I said it was a long time ago, but 8-track? Come on, no, it was vinyl.
What technology or app is saving your life right now?
Right now it's WhatsApp, because it's allowing me to stay in contact with all my family and friends. Don't watch your step.
Thanks, Kris. Do you have any mentors or people who inspire you?
Yeah, I'd have to say my parents. I mean, they taught me everything I know and really set me on my journey that I'm on now.
What's the best advice you've ever been given?
Be yourself.
Hey, can you skate backwards?
Yeah, sure can. Has been a while, but let's give it a try.
What are you most looking forward to about living in the Twin Cities?
Baseball. I love Twins games. I love baseball. Only have one team in Canada. Now there's one in my hometown.
What will you miss about Canada?
Well, my friends, but hopefully I'll be able to make a few here.
Did you actually move here for better weather?
Of course. Doesn't everyone move south for better weather?
Do you know what hot dish is yet?
No. Sven and Alicia have kind of given me a few hints. They said we're going to make one soon, so I'll have to find out all about that.
Is it duck, duck, goose or duck, duck, gray duck?
Well, I've never heard about duck, duck, gray duck, so I'd have to say duck, duck, goose.
Don't worry. We'll bring you up to speed. By the way, it's duck, duck, gray duck. Do you cook?
I love to eat, so cooking is mandatory, but that's still a work in process. Very simple cook.
If you were on an adventure reality show, who would you choose as your partner?
That'd have to be Dwayne The Rock Johnson. He's got the strength to build everything we need and get that kind of stuff done. Also seems like he'd be an interesting conversationalist so we could pass the time.
Hey, what did Belinda Jensen hand you on your first day at KARE 11?
Hand warmers, which of course I forgot today, but it was a lovely welcoming gift.
Well, that's all the questions I have. Thank you for your time, Kris, and welcome to Minnesota.
Thank you very much, glad to be here. If you don't mind, I'm going to take a rip around the ice here, do a few laps, and remember, catch me and the team weekdays on KARE 11 Sunrise from 5 to 7.